Your Royal Highness, the Crown Princess of Denmark, Director General Dr. Tedros, Regional Director for Europe Dr. Kliege, Madam President of the Regional Committee Ogerta Manastirliu, Honorable Ministers and Delegates, ladies and gentlemen. It has been a year and a half since the WHO declared the COVID-19 pandemic. Battling the pandemic continues to be one of the key priorities all around the world, placing health very high on the agenda in politics, security, and the economy. The health crisis has revealed that a great deal remains to be learned if we are to overcome similar challenges in the future. Complete and transparent probe in Wuhan is necessary to determine the origins of the virus. This will help us obtain the data needed to identify and prevent future pandemics. At the brink of the fourth wave of the pandemic, we not only have to deal with unequal access to vaccines, but also with misinformation and vaccine hesitancy, all of which leads to insufficient immunization rates and prevents a return to normal life. By donating €500,000 to the COVAX, Slovenia has contributed to the global vaccine sharing. Slovenia has been especially efficient in the vaccine rollout per capita, with almost 500,000 doses donated to Bosnia and Herzegovina, Egypt and Cabo Verde, and these efforts will continue until necessary. Bearing in mind that one of the Slovenian presidency's priorities in foreign policy is the Western Balkans, we pay special attention to this part of Europe in all fields and warmly welcome the roadmap for health in the Western Balkans 2021-2025, the initiative led by the WHO Regional Office of Europe. Strategic investment in health will definitely contribute to the successful realization of the existing plans for other investments in the region. We live in an unprecedented time in the history of the humankind. There are still many unknowns regarding the consequences of the pandemic and future challenges in the health sector. COVID-19 still possesses a high risk, endangering the lives and well-being of people, especially in vulnerable populations. However, we must never lose faith in humanity. The two key words of the COVID crisis are science and solidarity. By pooling our scientific and technological capacities, we have managed to respond very quickly, but now we need solidarity at the global level to win the battle in the long run. The health systems, which have been under extreme stress, now need substantial investments and innovations to become more robust and resilient. For this to happen, we, prime ministers and ministers of finance, must put health even higher on our agenda. I warmly welcome the initiative of WHO Euro to establish a special pan-European commission on health and sustainable development. It is important that the commission's report launched last week will also be presented at G20 and other forums where financing priorities are discussed at the global level. It is time to spend now so that we can save in the future. Thank you very much.